Let us not forget this mystery of divine standard. Otherwise, we will be tempted to brag about our achievement and bask in the laurels of apparent success. Again, St. Paul reminds us, what do you have that you have not received? Walang palatayo may kapayapaan sa mundo ito. At walang dahilan upang tayo ang mayaman. In humility alone, we will be able to understand the mystery of our priesthood. Priesthood is a ministry, a life of service, in particular to the poor. As pastors endowed with the mission of Christ, the sharing of his triple function, we are to minister to all, both learned and unlearned, rich and poor, the powerful and the powerless. Jesus is identified with the poor. He says, foxes have dens and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. A poor Christ. In the context of Philippine society, where a big chunk of the population lives below poverty line, we priests must be at home more with the poor and not with the rich and the powers of the people. When Pope Francis reminds us to go out to the periphery of existence and to have the smell of the ship, of the flood, this is not so much in geographical sense, rather in economic sense. If we are truly with the poor, anyway, we should be sensitive as to how we live, move, and exist. We should see to it that our living room resemble not that of our bachelors, but rather of a man of God who knows clearly the distinction between what is necessary from what is and looks like. We need to see the clothes that we put on are not far away from the ordinary people who would wear with dignity rather than signature one so much so that a single piece of that would be enough to buy clothes for one family for their Christmas celebration. Kailangan natin isasayang ng kapag-ikumpare. Kung mahirap, kung ang ating buhay ay identified sa mga manihirap at hindi natutungo sa atin, sa paglaki nila sa atin, ang mga kuspa. How can we serve the least when there are five walls that separate us from them and we create great things that render us almost inaccessible? The priesthood is truly lived in sanctity. Blessed Mother Teresa of Calcutta wrote some years ago, God has not called me to be successful, He called me to be faithful. Saint Jose Maria Escrivá used to say, these world crises are crises of saints. In other words, applying this to us priests, the priests that the church needs today are priests who strive to be holy, making it our foremost goal, the mother of all goals. We have enough goals. St. Paul tells us, for this is the your sanctification. I'm sure we priests, we always think and preach about sanctity in our homes. Let us walk the talk. Let it be seen in our concrete lives as people hear this from our lips. Without a sincere striving for sanctity, the vocation to the priesthood may be watered down to be a mere profession by which one is earning a living, rather than winning souls for Christ. Amen. Sapagkat kami po ng 25 taon ng pagpapari, dalangin ko, dalangin ang handa natin ito, ay patuloy kang maging daluyan ng biyaya at awan ng Panginoon. Bigyan ka rin naman lagi ang kalusugan ng katawan at kaluluwa. As you know, over 3 decades ago, our silver jubilee was my sacristan mayor. He was giving me incalculable help as a young priest. First, for a few months in Victoria, Laguna, his hometown. I have so many beautiful memories of that town, which is to be speaking. Then in Balibago Parish, for a year, you and Jose Lito, who is also another priest, incarnated in the Diocese of Frascati in Italy, in the suburb of Rome. Dalawa po itong naging pare na kasama ko sa kundal. Allow me therefore, as a senior brother in the priesthood, to bless you with fraternal affection, with a priestly blessing from the Book of Numbers. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May He make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and keep you. At muntos anos, mudando de direção.